My name's EposVox, and I'll be discussing the live commentary and multi-track recording capabilities of the Elgato Game Capture HD software. I will have other tutorials on Elgato's capture cards and a plethora of other technology topics on my channel. So be sure to subscribe if you found this video helpful, and check the YouTube card icon above or description below for a playlist with my other Elgato gaming-related videos. Per overwhelming popular request, Elgato incorporated the ability to record live commentary voiceover alongside your gameplay from within their software. This has also led to a ton of new streaming features that I've covered in previous videos. This is great for doing live gaming sessions, tutorials, and live streams, or just vlogs in a gaming format. It's also incredibly easy to set up. To set up live commentary, simply navigate to the Live Commentary section below Game Audio on the Capture tab of the software. Here, you have a few important options to consider. First, next to the microphone symbol, choose your microphone input. If you plugged in a wired analog headset via 3.5mm connection, the connector is sometimes pink, if that helps, then your mic might show up as microphone-realtek high-definition audio or sound blaster or something like that. Otherwise, for USB mics and interfaces, they should show up by name, such as Blue Snowball or Focusrite Scarlett 2i2. If all else fails, just open up Windows recording devices and see which one lights up when you talk. That will help narrow it down. Select the appropriate mic. I do some test talking here to make sure your microphone isn't peeking too far into the red. Before it shows up, however, you need to jump to the bottom of the software and click the big blue microphone circle for commentary down by the recording controls. This activates your microphone and your volume meter under live commentary should start lighting up. If not, check your microphone selection and settings again. Next, adjust the volume dial to your liking. At your loudest point, think smacking your lips or shouting at a jump scare. The meter should go into the orange and low red. Do some shouting to test. Next is a very important decision. Consider your goals for recording or streaming. If you plan to edit everything in a separate video editor, such as Vegas Pro or Premiere Pro, and can manage multiple audio tracks, then you don't need to do anything. However, if you're live streaming, hoping to just record and edit in the Game Capture HD software or upload straight to a site like YouTube, then you may want to check the Automatically Reduce Game Sound checkbox. Otherwise, your game sound could overpower your voice commentary and no one would be able to hear you. Either way, do some testing before committing to long recording sessions. You'll save yourself a lot of headaches with just a couple quick test recordings. Alternatively, you could do those test recordings and then lower your game's audio levels so that it's constant, but your voice is still audible. You'll want to set this up well in advance before you do an important recording or live stream. Clicking the speaker icon will loop your voice back to you so you can hear yourself if your setup doesn't already do that for you. The gear icon here gives you some more advanced control over the automatic reduction and attenuation to your mic and allows you to make it mono, which is important for some higher-end audio hardware. That's all you need for basic live commentary recording. Make sure the blue commentary circle is lit up and hit record. However, exporting your videos can be a little more complicated. Going back to the goal of recording that I mentioned before, you need to decide if you want your live commentary exported with your game audio, if you balance the volume levels already, or exported to separate audio files for you to balance in your video editor. To access multi-track export options, select the gear icon in the very top right-hand corner of the Game Capture HD software, and then click the Sharing tab. At the bottom, you have two main sets of checkboxes. One set is for mixing tracks into the final game video file or exporting things to separate files. In this video, we're only looking at the live commentary audio checkbox. For a breakdown of the full options, check out my recording settings video in the playlist in the YouTube card icon above or description below. Here, you can choose to embed the live commentary audio within the main video export, mixing it with your game sound. This is fine if you balanced your audio levels already or enabled automatically reduce game sound. If you want this, check the box next to Live Commentary Audio below the Mix the Following Tracks to Exports heading. Otherwise, you'll want to export your live commentary audio to a separate audio file to bring into your video editor. To do this, check the box below the Export to Separate Files header. While you can technically check the checkbox under both headers, that will get a little confusing because then you'll have the video with your live commentary baked into your gameplay audio and a separate file with your gameplay audio, and when you try to mix that back up, it may sound a little funky, so you probably want to commit to one or the other. Now, whenever you go to the Edit tab and export your videos by clicking the File MP4 option in the Share section, you'll either be given the game video and audio mixed with your live commentary in a single MP4 file, or the game video and audio in the MP4 file and a separate M4A file with your live commentary. If you ever need to export just one aspect of a recording, select your video under Videos, let it load, and then right-click the timeline, and you can choose Save Game Audio Only or Save Live Commentary Only, and so on. This is useful if you screw something up in editing or your first time exporting didn't work for some reason. Lastly, you need to import the files into your video editor and edit. In programs like Premiere and Vegas, it's easy to just pull your game footage into your timeline, then drop the audio file for the live commentary onto a second audio track. Then use the volume level controls to adjust the volume of each so it sounds good, and you're good to go. If you're using an interface or a mic that only sends audio out over the left or right channel, leaving the other empty and providing a one-sided audio stream, you'll want to separate those audio tracks into mono files. Unfortunately, Audacity cannot open the M4A files provided by Elgato by default, though Adobe Audition will. To open the files in Audacity, you need to download the FFmpeg plugin, which is free and easy to install. The download link will be in the description below. Both of these tools will split the file easily, however. Once you've installed the plugin, drag the file into Audacity and click the drop-down arrow next to the file name and click Split Stereo to Mono. Then delete the empty track and export your audio again as a .wav file and import that into your video editor in place of the original file. In Adobe Audition, simply right-click the audio file or waveform and click Extract Channels to Mono Files and save the appropriate mono file. And again, import it back into your video editor. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, Falcon, pounce that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and check out the description below. There, I have a link to the playlist with all of my Elgato gaming tutorials and reviews, so check them out. I also have product links to each Elgato capture card if you're looking to buy one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.